While we're in the midst of football season, don't forget it's playoff time in baseball. The Yankees are battling the Indians in one series, and there's a unique connection to our area to share. David Yonkai from the LULAC Political Letter joins us now with more. Hey, David.
Great you are here
today.
Thank you.
So I have some interesting questions for you. So is it true political bloggers are more inclined to love baseball?
Yes, because politics is a strategic game, and baseball is a game full of strategy. So I think that you'll meet a lot of political bloggers who would really be into baseball.
Wonderful. It's very interesting. And the division series between the Yankees and Indians is now underway. I'm dying to know, what is this local connection?
Well, the local connection with the Yankees, basically, there's more Yankee fans than Indian fans here, but the Yankees basically had a couple of baseball players in the 50s who played with that team. Joe Ostrowski from West Wyoming was a Yankee pitcher, and a guy named Joe Glenn from the Tunkhannock area also was on the Yankees, and he actually roomed with Babe Ruth. The connection with the Indians is that the Indians had a farm team here in the 1940s and 50s, and the players that you see on the screen there, they were on the last championship team, but they also played for the Wilkes-Barre Barons. The manager of the Barons was a guy named Bill Norman, and Norman actually became a major league manager later, and he had championships for the old Penn New York League between 1949 and 1952. Don't feel bad, because I wasn't even born then yet when all that stuff happened, so, okay?
Well, this is so interesting to learn about. So I need to know, how did you become an Indians fan?
When I was 9 years old, I hit the childhood disease trifecta of mumps, measles, and chickenpox all at the same time.
Oh, my God.
And I was quarantined in my room for, like, 5 weeks.
Oh.
And at night, I would be listening to a radio station out of Cleveland, and I actually became a Cleveland Indian fan because the Indians, like me as a baseball player as a kid, they weren't great, they weren't bad, they were just right in the middle, and I thought, that's my team.
Oh my gosh, I love it. And they were zoomed in on your tie just a few seconds ago, so let's talk about this tie you're wearing.
Well, I'm wearing a Cleveland Indian tie, and this is a much more tasteful tie because, as you can see, it has a little Indians logo, but I have other ties that have big Indians logos, but I thought we'd
it matches so perfectly. Oh,
well,
it's a good combo there.
Appreciate that.
And are there other local diehards who are Indian fans?
Yes. Not as many Yankee fans as the Indians have less fans than the Yankee fans, but the Indian fans are diehards. Let me share a story with you. In 2008, I was diagnosed with colon cancer, and I had to have a very serious operation. And you know how the surgeon, before you go into surgery, you know, he'll come into the room and he'll talk to you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I looked up at him, and he had a surgical skull cap on, and underneath the surgical skull cap was a bandana that had the Cleveland Indian logo. So I thought to myself, I'm in good hands with this guy. 9 years cancer-free. Dr. Pernikoff, if you're listening, hope we win this year, because
he's
the guy that essentially saved my life.
That definitely makes you feel good, you know,
going
in there with that. Wow.
And he's following the Indians just like all the other Indian fans in this area.
I love it. Well, these were some great stories. Thank you so much for coming on and sharing with us.
I'm very happy to be here, and I enjoy working with you.
All right. Well, we will talk soon. For now, let's just head over to Dave.